Good morning, my dear children. Today I am going to start with a new lesson in English 1, The Ungrateful Crocodile. Before that, everyone be ready with your Sparrow Sem 1 textbook and take out page number 28. Everyone be ready with your Sparrow Sem 1 textbook. Take out page number 28. Okay, before starting the lesson, let me read the lesson for you. Okay, children? Children, you are ready with your textbook, no? Lesson number 5. The Ungrateful Crocodile. Okay. Once upon a time, a monkey lived on a blueberry tree by a river. The monkey was alone as he had no friends or family. But he was happy and content. The tree gave him plenty of sweet blueberries to eat. It also gave him shade from the sun and shelter from the rain. A crocodile and his wife lived in the same river. One day, while the crocodile was swimming up the river, it climbed onto the bank to rest under the monkey's tree. "Hello," called the monkey, who was a very friendly animal. "Hello," replied the crocodile, surprised. "Do you know where I can get some food?" the crocodile asked. "I haven't had anything to eat all day and I am very hungry." The kind monkey offered him a few blueberries. The crocodile enjoyed them very much and asked the monkey whether he could come again for some more fruit. The generous monkey happily agreed. The crocodile returned the next day and the next. Soon the crocodile was visiting the monkey every day. The two became very good friends. They discussed their lives, their friends and family. Go to the next page, children. Like all friends do, the crocodile told the monkey that he had a wife and they lived on the other side of the river. So the kind monkey offered him some extra blueberries. He said, "Please take some fruit for your wife as well when you go back today." The crocodile's wife loved the blueberries. She had never eaten anything so sweet before. She made her husband promise to get her some blueberries every day. Meanwhile, the friendship between the monkey and the crocodile deepened as they spent more and more time together. The crocodile's wife started getting jealous. She wanted to put an end to this friendship, so she thought of a plan. One day, she pretended to be very ill and told the crocodile that the doctor said that she would only recover if she ate a monkey's heart. If her husband wanted to save her life, he must bring to her his friend's heart. The crocodile went to the blueberry tree and invited the monkey to come home to meet his wife. The monkey was very pleased but said he could not possibly go because he did not know how to swim. "Don't worry about that," said the crocodile. "I will carry you on my back." The monkey agreed and jumped onto the crocodile's back. Go to the next page, children. In the middle of the river, the crocodile thought that the monkey was fairly caught and there was no escape. So he revealed his secret plan to kill him. He told the monkey that his wife was sick and wanted his heart. The monkey realized that he had been foolish to trust the crocodile. He quickly thought of a clever plan to escape. He said, "Alas, friend, our hearts are not inside us. We have to keep them hanging on trees. I wish you had told me earlier."
Let's go back and bring my heart. The crocodile believed the monkey and brought him back to the tree. Now go and fetch your heart, hurry up, said the foolish crocodile. The monkey quickly jumped off his back and climbed into the safety of his tree. I thought you were my friend, he said. Don't you know that we carry our hearts within us? I will never trust you again. Give your fruits from my tree. Go away and don't come back again. The crocodile felt really foolish. He had lost a friend and a supply of good sweet fruit. The monkey had saved himself because he had thought quickly, but from that day on, he never trusted crocodiles again. Once upon a time, a monkey lived on a blueberry tree by a river. So where does the monkey live, children? Monkey was living on a blueberry tree by a river. So by a river, the monkey was living under a blueberry tree. The monkey was alone and he had no friends or family. The monkey was living very alone and he was not having any friends or family. We all have friends and family. We all live with our parents, grandparents, no? But monkey is staying alone and he doesn't have any friends. But he was happy and content. But monkey was alone, no? He was happy and content. Content means he was satisfied with what he had. The tree gave him plenty of sweet blueberries to eat. Where he was living under a blueberry tree, no? The same tree was giving him sweet blueberries to eat. He was not bothered about the food also. He was getting sweet blueberries to eat. It also gave him shade. So it also gave him shade. If it is too sunny, no, he has to be under the tree, no? So tree gave him a shade, but from the sun. And shelter from the rain. So shelter from the rain. He was very safe. Who? Monkey. A crocodile and his wife lived in the same river. Even the crocodile is also living in a same river. One day while the crocodile was swimming up the river. Can you see here? The crocodile is swimming up the river. It climbed onto a bank to rest under a tree. When the crocodile was swimming, he wants to take some rest. So he climbed onto the bank to rest under the monkey. So he started swimming, no? So he wanted some rest. So he came to bank to rest under the tree. What do you mean by bank? The other side of the river. Okay. A crocodile and his wife lived in the same river. Even the crocodile is also living in a same river. One day while the crocodile was swimming up the river. Can you see here? The crocodile is swimming in the same river. It climbed onto the bank to rest under the monkey's tree. So he got tired. No, so crocodile need rest. So it climbed on the bank to rest under the monkey's tree. What do you mean by bank? The other side of the river side. So he wanted to rest. So he wanted to rest here. Okay. Monkey's tree. Hello, called the monkey. So monkey saw the crocodile. So monkey is saying hello, called the monkey. Monkey is saying hello to whom? To the crocodile, who was a very friendly animal. So here monkey is a very friendly. Monkey is a very friendly animal. Hello, replied the crocodile. Even when monkey said hello, even crocodile said hello. But crocodile was very surprised. Do you know where I can get some food? Here, crocodile is asking to a monkey. Do you know where I can get some food? To whom? Crocodile is asking to a monkey. Do you know where I can get some food? The crocodile asked to a monkey. I haven't had anything to eat all day and I am very hungry. So here crocodile is saying to a monkey, I haven't had anything to eat all day. The whole day he was not having anything. I am very, very hungry. So here crocodile is asking to a monkey. The kind monkey offered him a few blueberries. So when he was asking, I am so hungry, no? So what did monkey do? So the monkey offered some blueberries. The crocodile enjoyed them very much and asked the monkey whether he could come again for some more fruit. So the crocodile was very, very happy when monkey offered the blueberries. So what did crocodile say to a monkey? Crocodile enjoyed them very much and asked the monkey whether you could you could come again for some more fruit. And can you give me a fruit every day? So who is asking? The crocodile is asking to a monkey. The generous monkey happily agreed. Yes, the monkey said, yes, I'm going to offer every day. What is going to offer? The blueberries. The crocodile returned the next day. So again the next day, crocodile returned the next day. And the next, soon the crocodile was visiting the monkey every day. So every day the crocodile started visiting a monkey. They two became very good friends. Who? Crocodile and monkey. They became very good friends. They discussed their lives and friends and family. So when you became very close to your friends, know what you will do? You'll start discussing about your family, your friends. No, same way here. The crocodile and monkey, they became very close to each other and they started discussing about their lives and their friends and family. Okay, children, go to the next page. Like all friends do, we all do the same thing. No, when we become very close to your friend, we start discussing about your family, to whom you all stay, along with your grandparents, along with whom, which is your favorite food. Same way here, they both were discussing who, monkey and a crocodile. The crocodile told the monkey that he had a wife and that they lived on the other side of the river. So here crocodile is discussing about his family. The crocodile told the monkey that he had a wife. Who is having a wife? Crocodile. And they lived on the other side of the river. Can you see here? This is one side of the river. The other side of the river, the crocodile and his family are living. So the kind monkey offered him some more extra blueberries. So when the crocodile was discussing about his family, so monkey offered some more extra blueberries to whom? To give his wife. He said, please take some fruit for your wife. So here monkey is saying to the crocodile, he said, please take some fruit for your wife as well. When you go back today, when you go back to your home, take some fruit to your wife, offer her. The crocodile wife loved the blueberries. So when he back to home, the crocodile wife loved the blueberries. So she started loving the blueberries. She had never eaten anything so sweet before. Here, crocodile wife is saying, I never eaten this before. It is so sweet. Okay, what is so sweet? The blueberry. She made her husband promise to get her some blueberries every day. So she took promise from his husband, you have to get blueberries every day. So here she's taking promise from her husband. Meanwhile, the friendship between the monkey and the crocodile deepened as they spent more and more time together. The friendship between the crocodile and the monkey, they're very, very, very close. So here what is happening? The crocodile wife started getting jealous. See, if somebody is very close, no, the other person will started getting jealous. No, here same thing is happening. When two friends are very close, the third person will get jealous. Same way here, when the crocodile and the monkey is very close, the other third person, who is the third person? The crocodile wife is getting jealous. Why? Because crocodile is very close to a monkey. So what happened? She had planned for something. Let us see what she planned. She wanted to put an end to this friendship. So she's thinking, I wanted to put an end to this friendship. So she thought of a plan. So she planned to end for this friendship. So she thought of a plan. What is the plan? Let us see, children. One day, she pretended to be very ill and told the crocodile that the doctor said that she would only recover if she ate a monkey's heart. One day what happened? She pretended. What do you mean by pretended? She started lying. To whom? To his husband. So she pretended to be very ill, means she is not feeling well, and told the crocodile that the doctor said that she would only recover if she eat monkey's heart. So she visited to doctor and doctor said, if she eat only monkey's heart, I'm going to recover, or else I'm not going to recover. Here wife is saying to crocodile, to his husband. Okay, again I'm going to repeat. So one day she was very ill, so and told the crocodile that that the doctor said that she would only recover if she eat only monkey's heart. Only you're going to recover only by eating monkey's heart. Here wife is lying to his husband. If her husband wanted to save her life, he must bring to her his friend's heart. So if her husband wanted to save her life, if she wanted to save her life, no, what he wanted to do? He must bring to her his friend's heart. If crocodile wants to save his life, so he wants to get his friend's heart. Whose heart? Monkey's heart. Okay, the crocodile went to the blueberry tree. So what he wanted to save his wife's life, no? So the crocodile went to the blueberry tree and invited the monkey to come home to meet his wife. Here crocodile is lying to a monkey. The crocodile went to the blueberry tree and invited the monkeys to come home to meet his wife. So the crocodile went to blueberry tree and invited the monkeys to come home to meet my wife. So he is calling, you please come to my home to meet my wife. Who is asking here? Crocodile is asking to monkey. For what? To meet my wife. The monkey was very pleased. Pleased means happy. But said he could not possibly go because he did not know how to swim. So your monkey is saying, I'm very happy that you're calling me to my house to meet your wife, but it is not possible to me. Why? Because he don't know how to swim. Who? Monkey don't know how to swim. Don't worry about that. So crocodile is saying, don't worry about that. Said the crocodile, I will carry you on my back. I'm going to carry you on my back. So can you see here? The crocodile is carrying on his back. So I will carry you on my back. The monkey agreed and jumped onto the crocodile's back. So monkey is very happy to see his wife. No, so monkey doesn't know how to swim. So when the crocodile told, I'm going to carry on my back, the monkey agreed and jumped onto the crocodile's back. So monkey, all of a sudden, he jumped on his back and they started going to meet his wife. Let us see what happened. Go to the next page. In the middle of the river, the crocodile thought that the monkey was fairly caught and there was no escape. So in the middle of the river, the crocodile thought that the monkey was fairly caught. He is thinking that I'm going to save my wife's life, and now monkey can't even escape. So he revealed his secret. So he wanted to reveal his secret plan to kill him. He told that monkey that his wife was sick and wanted his heart. So in between of the river when they were swimming, no, the crocodile revealed his secret plan to kill him. He told that we are going to kill you. He told that monkey that his wife was sick, that the wife is very sick, no, she is not feeling well, no, so she wanted to eat his heart. Whose heart? Monkey's heart. The monkey realized that he had been foolish. So the crocodile foolish the monkey, no. The monkey realized that he had been foolish. I'm so foolish. Who is thinking? The monkey is thinking in his mind to trust the crocodile. The monkey realized that he had been foolish to trust the crocodile. He quickly thought of a clever plan. They had a secret plan, no. Now they have revealed his plan. So now monkey plan for a clever plan. What is that plan? He quickly thought of a clever plan to escape. So he wanted to escape from a crocodile. He said, alas friend. Who is telling? Alas friend, our hearts are not inside us. So here monkey is saying, our hearts are not inside us. We have to keep them hanging on trees. Here monkey is saying, alas friend, our hearts are not inside us. My heart is not inside us. We have to keep them hanging on trees. Have to keep that hanging on trees. Who is saying? Monkey is saying to a crocodile, because he wanted to escape from the crocodile. I wish you had told me earlier. You would have told me this earlier, no? Let's go back and bring my heart. Here crocodile is saying, my heart is not with me. It is hanging on tree. Let us go back and let us bring back my heart. I wish you had told me earlier. Let's go back to a blueberry tree and bring my heart. Here monkey is saying to a crocodile. The crocodile believed the monkey and brought him back to the tree. So in the same way, how monkey believed the crocodile, no? What he planned, he wanted to meet his wife. He told him and he took him. No, same way here, the monkey foolish the crocodile. He said, my heart is not with me. I'm going to hang the heart in the tree. Let us go back and bring my heart. The crocodile believed the monkey and brought him back to the tree. So the crocodile believed that and he brought the monkey back to his tree. Now go and fetch your heart. Now crocodile is saying, now go fast and get your heart. Here the crocodile is saying to the monkey, go hurry up, go get your heart. Said the foolish crocodile. So crocodile is saying to a monkey, go fast and get your heart. The monkey quickly jumped off his back. So when he reached to his tree, the monkey quickly jumped off his back and climbed into a safety of his tree. So when as soon as he reached to the river, to his tree, so monkey quickly jumped off his back and climbed into a safety of his tree. He wanted to be safe, no? So he quickly jumped and he went to his safe place. I thought you were my friend. Who is saying? Monkey is saying to a crocodile, I thought you were my friend, he said. Who is saying? Monkey is saying to a crocodile. Don't you know that we carry our hearts within us? So here, monkey is saying to a crocodile, don't you know that we carry our hearts within us? I will never trust you again. I will never trust you again. I will never trust you again or give you fruits from my tree. Go away and don't come back again. Here monkey is saying to a crocodile, don't you know that we carry our hearts? Children, we have our hearts within us only. No, same way here, even for the animals have their hearts within them only. But here the monkey foolish the crocodile, because the crocodile wife wanted to kill monkey, no? So monkey foolish the crocodile. So they came back to this tree and monkey is saying, don't you know that we carry our hearts within us? I will never trust you again. The monkey is saying, I will never trust you again or give you fruits from my tree. I'm not going to trust you or I'm not going to give you fruit from my tree. Go away and don't come back again. Here monkey is in safe place and he is telling to a crocodile, go away and don't come back again. Don't come back again. The crocodile felt really foolish. He had lost a friend. So he lost his friend and a supply of good sweet fruit. He was not getting a fruit. But the monkey was offering a sweet blueberries and he was offering to his wife also. But now he lost his friend also and he lost his food also. The monkey has saved himself because he had thought quickly. The monkey had saved himself because he thought himself quickly. But from that day on, he never trusted crocodiles again. So he trusted his friend so much. But what did the crocodile do? The crocodile wanted to kill him because the crocodile wife was very jealous that monkey and crocodile was very close. But here, what did at last he do? He wanted to foolish the monkey. At last, what happened? He lost his friend and he lost his food also. So what you have to do, children, you never ever has to foolish anyone. Okay, I hope you have understood this lesson. So read this lesson, go through this lesson. Okay, in case if you have any doubt regarding this, you can ask me in the interactive session. Let me read the meanings for you once. Okay children, page number 31, meanings: content, satisfied, shelter, protection, generous, kind, jealous, envious, recover, get well, secret, hidden, clever, intelligent, trust, have faith in, shade, cover, bank, here or riverside, depend, hear or increase, pretended, to appear falsely, revealed, confessed, realized, understood, safety, here, safe place. Children, you have to read the meanings and read the lesson. If you have any doubt, you can ask me in the interactive session. Okay, children, thank you.